गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, दिस इज एम राजशेखर वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग सेमार्टिन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज एंड आई एम बिलोंग टू स्ट्रक्चरल इंजीनियरिंग स्पेशलाइजेशन एंड टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिलीवर ए कंटेंट ऑन द स्ट्रक्चर एंड इट्स एनालिसिस स्ट्रक्चरल एनालिसिस एंड द डिटरमिनेंट्स टाइप्स ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर्स statically determined structure and statically indeterminate structure and the types of beams okay which are related to this indeterminacy okay what is this indeterminacy up to the beams okay which beam is statically determined or which beam is statically indeterminate right so let me start with the definition of structure first right so structure Structure. So structure, we know that structure is an assemblage of number of components, likely such as beam, slab, wall, columns, foundations, and so on, which remains in equilibrium. Right. So structure is an assemblage of number of components, likely such as beam, slabs, walls, columns, foundation, and so on, which remains in equilibrium. Right. So all these elements to be in equilibrium, then only we can call as it as a structure. Right. So not individually the structural elements can call them as a structure. Okay. All those elements to be in equilibrium. Right. So whenever we are talking about equilibrium, okay, we have a basic equilibrium equations, right? So those three basic equilibrium equations once we will recall, right? So basic equilibrium equations, those are sigma h equal to 0 and sigma b equal to 0 and sigma m equal to 0. So here the sigma h is nothing but the algebraic sum of, so the sum of the horizontal forces acting on a material or a beam. Right, so if sigma h equal to 0, sum of the horizontal forces acting on the beam that equal to 0, and sigma v, sum of the vertical forces acting on the beam equal to 0, and sigma m, sum of the moments due to the forces. Right, so we know that a moment is going to generate, a moment is going to raise whenever there are two forces acting on a particular beam in both the directions, right? So sigma h equal to 0, sum of the horizontal forces equal to 0, sum of the vertical forces sigma b equal to 0, and sum of the moments sigma m equal to 0. So these three are said to be the set of equilibrium equations, right? So as we know that for each different type of support, right, so the number of reactions will be different, right? So first of all, for each type of support we will write the number of reactions, right? So for a pinned or hinged support, right, so for a pinned or hinged support, the number of reactions are going to be two, only in the vertical direction as well as in the horizontal direction as well as in the vertical direction, as it is pinned or hinged to that particular beam or anything, right? So there will be no existence of moment, right? So next, for a fixed support, right, so whenever a support is fixed or rigid, okay, automatically not only the horizontal as well as vertical, a moment is also going to take place, right? So the number of reactions will be two forces plus one moment, so the number of reactions will be three. And coming to the roller support, right, so coming to the roller support, and the number of equilibrium equations, that will be only one, right? So if we provide roller support, okay, so it will move in the horizontal direction only, to and from moment, right? So the number of reactions will be one. Right, so now how these reactions are equilibrium or equations are interlinked, right? So on what basis we can is a determinate one or indeterminate one, right? So basically the structures, right? So structures, basically two different types of structures are there. One is a statically determinate structure. One is statically determinate, second one is statically indeterminate. Statically determinate structure and statically indeterminate structure. Okay, basically these are the two different types of structures. So on what basis we are calling the particular structure as a determinate one or indeterminate, right? So here we have a set of equilibrium equations that will be three, right? So for each type of beam, based on the support, okay, provided to that particular beam, okay, the number of reactions are going to be, okay, the number of reactions, it may vary. It depends upon the support, okay. If the number of reactions will maybe 6 or 10 or 3, sometimes there is only 2 reactions, okay, we cannot able to predict, right? So if the equilibrium equations, okay, whatever number of equilibrium equations 3 are there, right? So if equilibrium equations are alone itself is enough to solve a structural problem, right? So to find out the stresses, okay, within a stresses which are acting on your body, right? So if only with the help of equilibrium equations, if we can able to solve the structural problem or find out the stresses acting on the beam, then we can call that particular beam as a statically determinate one. If it's not possible for us to solve the structural problem only with the help of the equilibrium equations, right? So in that case, we can call the particular beam or structure, okay, as a statically indeterminate beam. Statically indeterminate beam, right? So let us quickly check the determinacy of each and every beam, right? So we have different types of beams. Okay, first we will start with a simply supported beam, right? So we know that simply supported beam is nothing but which is rested freely at its two ends, right? So two ends, those supports will be, one support is going to be pinned or hinged, and the second support, it is going to be a roller, right? So we know that for a pinned or hinged support, the number of reactions will be a horizontal and a vertical. So here at this particular support, the number of reactions will be 2. And for a roller support, only in the horizontal direction reaction is going to take place, that's why it is 1, right? So the total number of reactions will be 3, and our set of equilibrium equations, that is also 3. So 3 minus 3, that equal to 0. So if it comes, the answer of number of reactions minus number of equilibrium equations minus number of reactions, if it is 0, then we can call it as a statically indeterminate beam or structure. Okay, so simply supported beam is a statically determinated one, okay, where it consists of a pinned or hinged support, and on the other end it is a roller support, right? So let us come to the beam which is fixed, right? So fixed beam right? So for a fixed support, we know that the number of reactions are going to be 3 in the horizontal direction, in the vertical direction, and a moment, okay, because of the forces in both the directions. Here also same, right? So here also same, there will be 2 forces and 1 moment. So the number of reactions are going to be three, whatever the balance three we have, okay, that will be considered as a determinancy, indeterminacy of that particular beam, right? So fixed beam is a statically indeterminate beam, right? So now let us move on to the next type of beam, that is cantilever beam. Right, so we know that cantilever beam is nothing but which is fixed at one end while the other end is free. Right, so we know that the number of reactions a fixed support, okay, that will be three, and two reactions and one moment, and the number of equilibrium equations is also three. So 3 minus 3 then equal to 0. Right, so number of cantilever beam is going to be a statically indeterminate. Right, so similar to cantilever, proper cantilever is also one of the things. We know that proper cantilever is nothing but it is similar to the cantilever beam, but it consists of a load from a certain distance from the origin. Right, it is carrying the load, but at a certain distance, from a certain distance from the origin. Right, so in this case also the proper cantilever beam also it is a statically indeterminate one. And coming to the continuous beam. Continuous beam, we know that, okay, a beam which is having three or more supports, right? So those supports may be of any type, okay? They may be fixed ones are not all the sides are roller, only one side should be the roller, and one may be pivoted or hinged or anything, right? So if it is we know that if number of supports are more and more, right, so the number of reactions involved in that beam is also going to be more and more, right? So if the number of reactions will be more, right, so obviously that particular beam we can call it as a statically indeterminate beam. Why? Because if the supports, number of supports are increasing, automatically the number of reactions involved in that particular beam are also going to increase. Right, so then automatically it is going to be an unbalanced one, okay? It will not, the number of reactions are not going to be equal with the number of equilibrium equations, which are basically three. So the continuous beam is also going to be a statically indeterminate beam. Right, so next let us go with another beam, which is overhanging beam. Right, so overhanging beam is nothing but a beam which is extended beyond its supports. Right, so a beam which is extended beyond its supports. Right, so here the arithmetic representation of overhanging beam. Right, so this is what the extension. Right, so and this extension may be at any side. Right, so it may be on the right side or it may be on the left side. Right, so that depends upon the according to the situation. Right, so according to the structural problem or according to the type of structure. Right, so the extension may be on any side. It may be on the left side or it may be on the right side. So a beam which is extended beyond its supports, that particular beam we can call it as a overhanging beam. And here also. One type of support that is going to be fixed one, and on the other hand, right, so one more support, okay, that is depends on the problem, that is depends on the structure. It may be a pivoted one, or it may be a fixed one, or it may be a roller one, right? So depends upon the type of support they have given, okay? So depends upon that we need to calculate. We need to consider the number of reactions, okay? If it is fixed, that is 3, if it is a pivot, that is 2, if it is a roller, that is 1, okay? So based on the type of support, we need to consider the reactions, and then we need to calculate the determinancy, as we need to check the determinants of the structure, whether it is a determinate one or indeterminate one, okay? We need to calculate there, okay? By considering the equilibrium equation as well as the number of reactions. So this is what about the structure and the different types of statical independent structures and statical independent structures, and the types of supports, okay, with their respective reactions, and the different types of beams, and its determinants, right? So this is what about the determinants of structures. Okay, so thank you all for giving me this opportunity.